I applaud Congress for the timely passage of the train law. You have made funds available to build better roads, bridges, and improve health and education, and strengthen our safety and security. Some have incorrectly blamed our effort towards a fairer tax system for all the price increases in the past months, and some irresponsibly suggesting to stop train implementation. We cannot and should not. We need this for sustainable growth that leaves no Filipino left behind. Train is already helping poor families and senior citizens cope up with rising prices. We have distributed unconditional cash transfer to 4 million people and will help 6 million more this year. Following the 1 peso discount per liter in gas stations, we have also started releasing fuel vouchers to public utility, jeeps, and other valid franchises. Further, we have fast-tracked the distribution of energy rice to provide affordable rice for all. Excuse me. This year, we are giving 149 billion pesos worth of subsidies to the poor and vulnerable. Next year, the amount will be increased to 169 billion pesos. But no amount of subsidy can help the poor if some businesses take advantage of their situation to make more money. I ask businesses to cooperate with us in charging a fair price.